You might not be getting what you're paying for if you were to buy Alienware's new Ryzen-based m15 R5 gaming laptop today. I've got this laptop here to review, and while testing games, I noticed that the performance wasn't quite where it should be for an RTX 3070 laptop. In fact, it looks like 10% of the 3070's CUDA cores are missing. Just check out some of these benchmarks, comparing it against other laptops that I've tested that also have RTX 3070 graphics. In three different games, it's scoring the lowest out of the 7 3070 systems I've currently got data for. It's not too far behind, but this shouldn't be happening. The cheaper HP Omen 15 is beating it, and that has a lower tier CPU and lower power limit on the GPU. Not long after noticing this strange behavior, I was told by a few people about this Reddit thread where a number of M15 R5 customers were reporting that their new RTX 3070 models were reporting the wrong number of CUDA cores. According to the Nvidia spec, RTX 3070 laptop GPUs should have 5120 CUDA cores, and this is 10% more than what the M15 R5 is reporting through Nvidia's own control panel. So what's going on here? I reached out to my Alienware contact on the 3rd of June to try and find out, but unfortunately I haven't yet had a response. I also mentioned the issue on Twitter and had an automated reply from Dell support. After providing them with some basic details on my system, they replied with the following message on June 5th. Well, it was at like 4 AM for me, so I guess June 4th in the US. Anyway, the response starts with the usual, make sure you're using the latest BIOS and Nvidia drivers, which I was. Then they go on to say, which I'll directly quote here, CUDA core counts per the Nvidia baseline may change for individual OEM, such as ourselves, to allow to provide a more specific design and performance tuning. Be assured the changes made by our engineering team for this computer model was done after careful testing and design choices to bring the most stable and best performance possible for our customers. If at a later date more CUDA cores can be unlocked via a future update, we will be swift to make it available on our support website. So, based on this message, it sounds like it was intentionally done to tune the system. I thought this was quite interesting, because out of 100 plus laptop reviews, I don't think I've ever noticed a gaming laptop that had CUDA cores disabled like this. At the very least, I don't think it's common practice to tune the system. Most of the time, the OEM will instead lower the power limits to keep thermals in check. If a higher-end GPU with more CUDA cores can't run in a particular chassis, normally they just don't offer it. So if that's the case here, they probably shouldn't be offering it with the 3070. If the M15 R5 is selling with 10% of its CUDA cores disabled, then you're not getting RTX 3070 performance. It might not be too far off when compared to many other laptops with 3070 graphics, but in my personal opinion, I think it's a bit misleading when the benchmarks show us the R5 is the weakest 3070 option so far in terms of FPS in games. Some M15 R5 customers have been flashing the VBIOS from Alienware's R4 models to the R5, which apparently unlocked the remaining CUDA cores and improved performance. Though this has caused instability issues too and is not recommended. But this information helps confirm it appears to be a VBIOS issue. It's probably not just some random custom-made GPU for Alienware. At first I thought it might just be that the software was incorrectly reporting the CUDA core count, and that could be the case, but at the same time it's probably pretty unlikely given the gaming performance that we've seen from this laptop. Based on the actual performance that we did see from this laptop, it would make sense if 10% of the CUDA cores are just missing. Yesterday, some sites like Tom's Hardware reported on this issue, and they got a different response from Dell/Alienware than I did. This is what Tom's Hardware said that Dell told them. We have been made aware that an incorrect setting in Alienware's VBIOS is limiting CUDA cores on RTX 3070 configurations. This is an error that we are working diligently to correct as soon as possible. We're expediting a resolution through validation and expect to have this resolved as early as mid-June. In the interim, we do not recommend using a VBIOS from another Alienware platform to correct the issue. We apologize for any frustration this has caused. So, it's kind of hard to know which reply is correct. In the message to Tom's Hardware, they've clearly said it's a mistake and that they're going to fix it. But in the reply that I had from Dell support, they made it sound like they're more than happy to disable CUDA cores to tune the system. How you accidentally mess up and disable 10% of the CUDA cores, I can't say. So, did Alienware get caught in the act and now they're going to fix it? Or was it a genuine mistake and the support staff I were dealing with was simply misinformed? We might never know, but at least a fix is on the way. It's also not yet clear if this issue is also present in the M15 R6, which I believe is basically the exact same model as this, except it uses an Intel processor rather than Ryzen. I'm also very interested to retest this laptop once the update comes out. If they did have to lower the CUDA core count for thermals or something, then presumably with more CUDA cores, they might need lower power limit than what it currently has. Given I've already tested this laptop in 13 different games for my usual game benchmark video before knowing about this issue, I'm in a good position to compare before and after. It sucks that we're gonna have to spend another couple days retesting the laptop, but that's just the way it is. So if you're new to the channel, then get subscribed for the upcoming video where I'll compare the Alienware M15 R5 both before and after the VBIOS update. And of course for the upcoming full review video, which will be out sometime after that VBIOS update becomes available.